What is going on, beautiful people? Welcome back. It's your boy Blue, and this is Train Sim World 2. And what you're looking at now is a 1972 tube stock ready for southbound service from Queens Park Station to Elephant and Castle. This route is actually known as the Bakerloo Line of the London Underground, and both the train and the route are new to the Train Sim World franchise. I know a lot of you guys are excited for this route, so let's get started. All right, we'll start by unlocking the left side doors. And allow the passengers to board up. One cool thing that the Bakerloo kind of introduced was these signs up here that actually show the actual like times that the trains will be arriving, as well as the current time. So now it's time for us to lock doors. These doors don't stay open very long. All right, so doors are shutting up here at exactly 15:30. I'm gonna do my best to try to be on time. this time, back up to the front, we need to set the traction brake to control off. So there's shut down, there's emergency, you keep turning it. And there is off. And we're gonna acknowledge the audible warning there, which just sounds very weird. And then we'll apply some power and get going. So basically the brakes and the power are all in the same handle, the traction brake control. So if you go forward, or is it back? I think it's if you go back, it applies power, and if you go back forward, it applies brakes. So departing, I think it's Queens Park Station now, in the tube right now. Go ahead and try to maintain our speed. There's a guy there. We can use to try out the horn test. And we got another reward. So the speed limit right now is only 15 miles per hour, and we're already just in the first setting. As a matter of fact, we're coasting down the hill right now as we go down into the London Underground. And actually gonna have to add some power, sort of some brakes to try to keep this thing from going at a 3.3% gradient there at one point. So you can be hearing me hit the power handle quite often as we go right into the tunnels here. It's pretty cool. I'm not sure. I think the lights are on. They don't seem like extremely bright, but I think they're just not exaggerated. I think it's fine. But yeah, I mean, this underground portion really makes you feel underground. Like, I don't know if I can really explain that very well, but it feels like an underground network, which is always really curious to me, because, you know, you're in a big city like London, for example, and, you know, the transportation, here's our first stop, if I can make it. And it's just pretty amazing how they've designed all these tunnels here on the underground. So this is a look at the how the stations look here. This train actually has really good stopping power. It's not all that long, and it's pretty light. I mean, actually, I wouldn't say it's not that long. It's not short, but it's definitely very light. So it stops pretty darn quick. You can pretty much get on the power once you get on the inside. So we're gonna unlock the doors. That's gonna be on the right side. It's gonna be kind of hard to see that. If you open the doors up, we can kind of see passengers getting on and off. Get back in our seat and try to be on time. These underground networks, or these underground routes, go really quickly. It's very difficult and challenging to stay right on time. So we'll be leaving at 15:33, which is going to be about 15 seconds. So maybe we were a little bit early, which is surprising. Very surprising. But there's the horn. There's the whistle for you. The low one. Not sure if there's a high one. Yep, there's a high one. I kind of like the high one. Pretty cool. All right, departing in 10 seconds, so guys better hurry up and get on. Shut the door again. Getting impatient. All right, as soon as that door, man, the trains wait for no one. Doors locking on the right. And we're rolling already. Into shunt mode. This is the first setting. I believe it has three forward power settings. There's a series, shunt, and parallel. I'm not sure what the top speed of this train is. It's not like crazy fast or anything like that, but we're gonna push it. The next stop is only in, looks to be 600 yards. We're gonna stay up in the high power setting until we get there. Actually going to a slight low, a down gradient right now. And I'm gonna test out the stopping power of this train. Oh, all right, so there's our top speed, or not top speed, there's our speed limit. What is that, 30, 40? Let it coast now. Got even track. All right, here comes our next station. So I'm actually gonna wait to like 100 and start go right down on the brakes. It's not gonna be extremely comfortable, but hey, we're city transportation. And 5 yards, not bad, not bad. Oops, I didn't mean to get up. All right. Tab unlock right. You can also click on these red and black buttons here to open and close the doors on both sides. So I could click, I'm gonna do it to close it. So if the red buttons actually open the doors on that side and the black button shuts the door. So once that, there it is, lock the doors, I click on the black button and that's gonna shut the door. Now I will say, when you're down here in the London Underground, you're actually not able to go into the outside view. So if I click on the outside views, it's not gonna allow me to go to my exterior view, which, you know, it kind of makes sense because if I were to go in my exterior view, I'd be in like the tunnel, right? I would be like going through the walls, but I would at least kind of like to have like to be able to look at the doors when they open, whenever we stop at the different stops. And as well as sometimes I like to kind of make a free camera, or like a fixed camera. I like to have one right on the nose down there by the rails. I think it looks pretty cool, but you know, maybe they'll add it later, who knows. So again, all these stops are very close together. We're not doing the entire line right now. We're doing about like a 30 minute-ish portion of it. So only a few stops. Oh, I wouldn't say a few, there's actually quite a few stops. But you can see now, like they're all like maybe a mile apart from each other. Oh snap, I just realized we were speeding. Wasn't even paying attention. So we're coasting now. I'm going to go into brake mode 1. Holding it. Brake mode 2. And then brake mode 3. Because I don't think we're going to make that. Now going to max braking. Oh my god. I don't know if we're going to. Oh, we're going to overshoot just by a little bit. I am sorry. Oh, I set myself up for failure. But we're close enough. Unlock the right doors. And you guys are just going to not be able to use all the doors. My bad. Oh, I'm screwing it up already. It's not that hard, though. Honestly, the train brakes very easily. I think if you just maintain the posted speed limits, you should be pretty fine with stopping around 100 to 150 yards out, or at least starting to apply brakes around that time. So go ahead. I'm actually going to hit the user buttons. Lock to right. Horn. And we should be going. You shouldn't have to worry too much about signals. You do need to pay attention to the signals. The signals are a little bit different on the underground network. So they're honestly, in my opinion, easier to see because it's so dark down here. It's very hard to ignore a bright green light on a pitch black tunnel. So let's go ahead and crank it up. We gotta be the next stop by 1538. We're 850-ish yards away. It's gonna give us, what a 1 minute to get there. So I'm gonna try my best to stay on schedule. It's actually kind of fun. It's almost like you're racing the time. It's like a time trial, it feels like sometimes. All right, bring it down to a coast here as we're getting really close to that speed limit. Try to keep, so there's a green signal right there. That's what I meant, where it's like, it's really hard to ignore that green light. The speed limits will change though. That's something else that you do have to watch out for as you're going through here. You can't just gun it the whole way through. And already I'm gonna go, oops, I didn't even go to max. That's max brake. No! This is what I get for hitting the wrong button. All right, we're still on time. I can see the hole up there, or the exit of the tunnel. There's another train coming from the other way, which is pretty cool. Pretty cool, actually. I actually like watching the other trains come through the tunnels because they just barely fit through there. All right, applying brakes. Very interesting. Oh man, we're gonna be short this time. Oh boy. Yeah, all right, man. Brush up on your skills, my friend. I'm gonna hit the red button. Don't press the red button. This is one of those cases when you do actually get to press the red button. But man, I'm doing a horrible job so far. I'm gonna do better. So far we're on time, but our stopping distance has been off, very off. All right, lock the doors, black button. Again, I love the sounds, especially when you hear other trains coming from the other direction. That's one thing I really remember about the tunnels and underground networks, like in New York, is the loud sound they make when they go screeching through the tunnels. And I see our speed actually is only 20 or so, So I'm actually going to slow it down. There we go, now we're coasting. We need to be at the next stop by 15:40:15. So I need to really pay a lot more attention to these signals here. Signals and speed limits. The thing that I think it worries me is if I go too slow, I'm going to get there late. We're 30 seconds out. All right, there we go. Speed limit just got faster. This door up here is disabled, so if you're ever thinking of jumping through that door, there you go. There's the door does not open. Trust me, I thought about it. If you watch enough of my videos, you know that this thing, whenever you put a door in front of me like this, I'm just like, yeah, of course I want to see what happens if I jump through the door. But it does not work. All right, see if we can get this better this time. And here we go. Come on, give me right on the mark, baby. Right on the mark. That's close enough. I'll take that. That's progress right there. All right, unlock the left side door now. I actually use the other menu for that. I think we're at, what's this? Edgeware Road is the station we're at now. But I'll tell you, man, these trains do not wait long. If you are not here when the trains arrive, it will leave you. All right, lock the doors. That quick, like seconds, man. We're here for like 20, 30 seconds, and then we're out of here. All right, let's go. All right, so far on time. Not too bad. I'll take it. Back in the tunnel we go. You can hear a little bit of an area effect. Watching our speed here. Speed limit is only 25. There is a little bit of an area, like a sound, spatial sound effect when you whistle in the tunnels, but it's not extremely profound. But again, I don't know how often these guys even use their whistles. I feel like it's more of just a thing for people who love trains to just hit the horn. You know what I mean? I don't know how often they use the horn or what situation they use it. If you guys know, you could definitely let me know. But I'm not sure. All right, so we're rolling in. I think we're coasting. Yep, we're coasting into the next station, which looks like Marylebone. If you listen closely, that whoosh that just went by, that was actually another train on the other side of the station, passing by in the opposite direction. All right, unlocking the doors on the left side. But again, one of the things that's really cool about these underground networks is the sound. And you know, I'm sure a lot of you guys who are watching this have maybe been on this specific rail network, or even any other underground network. And one thing you will never forget is the sound. Let's go ahead and lock the door. That's a black button. And I feel like it's probably there's another train up ahead of us. All right, 15:43:15, and it's gonna give us just about a minute to get there. Only 500 yards, not too far. But you don't see, I mean, again, this is kind of the interaction you get with other trains. And I think that in the journeys, they time how and when the trains come through, just to give you a little bit more immersion, I guess you could say. All right, back to hold, actually. I actually just missed. I was trying to coast it. But yeah, they kind of have the timing of the other trains coming through just at the right moment, so you can feel like you're not alone. Because I definitely feel like you can get a bit lonely. Yes, lonely, while you're riding through these tunnels. So keep an eye out on our, it's gonna do like one, start stopping now. So I'm gonna do hold, we'll see how that goes. So you don't have to brake so aggressively. A lot better. So we stopped there right around the 120 marker. And that was actually gonna have us stopping a little bit short, I think. So I think if we stop right at the 100 marker, and we're good. Oh, are we late? I think we're just a little bit late. Oh no. Oh man, we need to get back on schedule. We're just like a few seconds late. I'm trying to get right on that thing, man. Usually on these passenger routes, especially these fast stop, you know, when there's a lot of stops, it's really hard to stay on schedule. You gotta be really on it. As soon as that thing comes down, lock the doors and get the heck out of here. It actually won't let you go until the doors are closed. So what I usually do, as soon as I hit the door lock button, I go ahead and start putting it in shunt or in forward and start moving. As soon as those doors shut, we can get out of here. So 15:45:15 is our next stop. That'll give us, what's that, a minute or so to go. Now there is an underground and a on the ground, I guess you could say, piece of this network. I don't know, not sure which part this journey is gonna take us on. It might just be underground, but there is a portion of this route that will be above ground. So don't think that the entire thing is all underground. So I'm basically gonna max out our speed. Next station is about 300 yards. It's a little less dark on this part, not sure why. Kind of managing our speed, just kind of playing with it. Oh my god, we hit that turn hard. Sheesh. All right, here it comes. So we stopped at 120 last time. There it is. Let's see if that works for us. Oh, I feel like we're coming in hot. We'll go into setting 2. And again, the signs in the station. Here's what's this, Regent Park. Not bad, that's closer. Red button. But yeah, the signs out there, if I can get up there quickly enough. Out here, actually, they actually update to show, you know, what's happening. All right, go, hurry. I believe they actually do update with the route. Go, lock the doors. Get in the seat. Black button, all right. Let's go. We're probably gonna be behind because I want to go adventure. All right, next stop, 15:47:30 at Oxford Circus. I believe this route does connect to, what's it called, Piccadilly Circus, and a few other places that are maybe familiar to a lot of people. The only reason I actually know about Piccadilly is from Call of Duty. From them, that was actually one of my favorite missions, by the way. You should definitely check it out. I had a whole mission just on that one. That was pretty fun. But I don't think we'll be stopping there today. So speed limit is about to drop to 25 right there, which I was not ready. Oh, I see why now. Woo! Listen to it. Yeah, I definitely see why that speed limit dropped to 25 right before that turn. Me being a horrible person. Listen to that. I don't know if the screeching is a bit more pronounced in Train Sim World 2. In Train Sim World 2020, it had screeching. It definitely had screeching of on the rails, but I don't know. I feel like I've noticed it a lot more in Train Sim World 2. In my opinion, it's not bad. I don't like it. It definitely, if you have your sound turned up high enough and you're not used to that sound, it kind of feels like nails on a chalkboard sometimes. To watch out for that. So we are actually 9 seconds early and we're a little slow. We're actually gonna probably stop right on time. Rode into the station about 9 seconds ago, and yep, there it is. There's our time, and we're gonna hit max on there and open up the left side doors. Red button. Not exactly sure how many stops we have, but one thing that is pretty nice is that you don't really feel like it's a long stretch of time where there's just nothing happening, because there's stations happening like every like 30 seconds to a minute long. All right, black button. Let's get out of here. All right, and we're gone. Actually, I was wrong. We are stopping at Piccadilly Circus. Speaking of Piccadilly, Piccadilly Circus is up next, 15:49. All right, bring that speed back to coast. We're actually going downhill. I got a 1.7% gradient now. Bring it back. There we go. We're good. All right, this one's a little bit farther. Actually, it's about the same. Most of these stops have been about 900 yards to a mile away from each other. Oh, I think I forgot that door open. Ooh, safety hazard. Just a minute away. It's a very dark tunnel right here. It's very challenging, especially when you're going to the underground, the lower gradient. So now we're actually going deeper underground. It's actually challenging. I think the speed limit is about the speed of 30. It's challenging to keep your speed, because even if you're coasting, you're still gaining speed and gaining momentum. And so you'll see me kind of hit the brake over and over here. Now the speed limit actually just went up, which I'm actually going to maximize on the time there and blast through here, try to get there a bit quicker. We're good on time though. We're looking good on time. This is actually a pretty nice big station here. Actually, now we're going fast. Alright, we're gonna need a little bit more brakes so I get this thing stopped. Maybe not. I was wrong. Wow. Yeah, it's just, that's the whole thing about train sims, especially doing passenger jobs. I mean, with freight, it's very similar as well. But with passengers, you stop so often and you're going so fast. You just gotta really figure out your stopping distance. It just takes practice. There we go. Red button. And we're here. Welcome to Piccadilly Circus. Yeah. It'd be really cool if I could actually see what's going on upstairs. Like, you can, I mean, if I wanted to not be on time, I could actually get out of the train, go out there, go up the stairs. I could hop on the stairs and go across over this tunnel into the other side and then catch the northbound train if I wanted to, but I think we're kind of busy right now. And I have tried to leave the station, and it does not work. You just kind of walk into an invisible wall. Like, you can actually see the street when you get up there, but you'll walk into an invisible wall. Like, try it, just try it, trust me. All right, speed limit up to, looks to be 25 now. And how are we doing on time? So far, it looks like we've been on time. Pretty good so far. Something I'm not used to. Oh no, 20. Yeah, I'm really doing a bad job with managing the speeds and with the speed changes. They're going mainly between 20 to 35 and then back to 20, depending on like this right here. Listen to that. Shoot, I need to just stop talking, let you guys hear the sounds. But here we go, coming up to Charing Cross. I don't know how to pronounce that. Probably pronounce that with some kind of English accent. All right, so I think we can stop a lot earlier, especially if we're coming in at 20 miles per hour. Here we go. And time check, it is 15, right on the dot, baby. We are right on time. We're killing this commute. All right, open at the right doors. Not sure how many more stops we have left, but we'll just keep on chugging. Oh, hello. Matter of fact, let's shut the doors, because these guys are just... look at this. What a creep. You've just been over here watching me. You know what? He might be a person who likes trains. You know what? It's cool. That's all good. I get it. I will do the same thing. All right. Door needs to be shut. Oh, that's open. That's closed. I get it. I got you, bro. You know what? I'm going to leave it open, because you're going to be in my position someday, I bet. Let's roll. I know it's a safety hazard, but I trust you, John. All right, next one's pretty close, so we got like seconds to get there. Like literally, like we had 45 seconds to get to this next stop. All right, watch the speed. We're a little fast. I'm really killing my action points right now. All right, after this next stop, hopefully it's not our last. After this next stop, I'm gonna do the next run without talking, so you guys can really hear all the sounds of the train and the route. Rolling in slowly. I like the way this one's designed. All these advertisement banners on the right. One thing that would really add a lot to this route would be filling up the station just a bit more. With it being around London, I know it is probably crazy busy. You know, just like walking room, standing room only. And we're stopped. Opening up the left side doors. Red button. Yeah, you look back here. He's gone now. Okay, well, I guess he doesn't want to hang out with us anymore. We got people standing and people sitting, which is actually pretty cool. But it'd be pretty sweet, you know. I don't know how hard that'd be on graphics, but it'd be pretty sweet if we could have, like, a cab full of people. Like, standing room only and people sitting. All right, shut the doors. All right, I'm going to shut up for this this next stop and let you guys enjoy the sounds. Almost missed it that time. But yeah, man, I think honestly, so far, one of my favorite things about this route, or this route, is actually the sounds. I really do like the sounds. We were actually like 10 seconds late that time, probably because we were messing around with the door last time. But we'll see if we can get back on schedule. Not too far off. We're probably not slowing anybody down behind us, but I'm not sure how tightly they pack these schedules here down here on the Bakerloo line. Shouldn't have too many more stops to go. Next up, 1556:30. That gives us exactly 1 minute to go 600 yards. Speed limit right now is 25, but we're about to get a 30 miles per hour change here, right there. And I think it should change once the back of our train passes it. I believe that's how it works. There it is. It just changed. Yeah, as soon as the final, I don't know if you would call it carriage, whatever the heck it's called, the final piece of the train, the end of your train, passes it, then, all right, so now we got another 25 miles per hour, so you really got to keep up with these speed limit changes. It goes from 25, 35, 35 to 20, and then you got to stop. All right, we need to hurry. We got 15 seconds to get there. A little fast. It'd be kind of cool if they had an airport stop. There probably is. All right, let's get stopped here. That works. All right, right side, right button. And now we're in Lambeth North. I'm not from around here, so I don't really recognize any of these city names, but I'm pretty sure some of you guys do who are from this part of the world. Door's locked. Let's see what our next time is we're trying to get to. All right, next up is Elephant and Castle. Actually, this will be our final stop. If I knew how to do train announcements, I would. I need to look it up and find out what they say. Next stop, Elephant and Castle. That's all I'm going to say for now. 1558:30. Let's see. It's our final stop. Let's see if we can get there before the time. Finish strong. It's only 700 yards out. 25 is the speed limit now. It's going to go down to 20 here in about 400 yards. We have an even gradient, so not going up, not going down. And so far, it seems like this whole thing has been in the tunnel. Some of the routes will actually take you above ground. I guess this is not one of them. Imagine. Oh, wait. Look at that. It's crazy. As you hit the turn. Oh, I think I hit the brake. My bad. I was going to say, as you hit the turn, the physics actually slow you down, which I think they do, but not that dramatic. All right. It is about to change back to 20 miles per hour. So when you get slowed up, we are 15 seconds out and we have a red light up ahead. Which means stop, obviously. This is our final stop of the day. And then we'll continue to our next service. Alright, here we go. One more farewell whistle. Ah, we're actually a little late. Oh, shoot. I keep getting the buttons mixed up for forward and back. We don't unlock the doors. We were like 15 seconds late or something like that. Something crazy. And while they're deboarding, we'll take a quick look at the back. So this is basically it. Like, there's nothing else. This is how it looks all the way back. It looks pretty close and similar to the real life thing. Thank you for completing this run. Let's see how you performed. All right. Well, let's see then. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Elephant and something. I wish they would make you hit a button to end. Like, I would like to kind of keep walking around. All right, let's see how we did, guys. Quite a few stops here as it's still going down. How many stops did we actually make? 15 stops on this route, 30 minutes. I like the 30-minute long. So time taken, only 23 seconds longer than we should have taken. Did pretty good staying on schedule for the most part. So actually says that we did arrive right on the time. We were on time, looks to be, for most of them except for platform 6... And a few others, but pretty darn good. We got a total score of 15,874 action points, and I'll take that. 6.9 miles driven. I definitely, that was cool. That was cool. I can dig that for real. Well, thank you guys so much for watching. We'd love to know your opinion on what you think of the London Underground Bakerloo line, as well as what is your opinion on Train Sim World 2 as a whole, as a game. How do you like it? What's your favorite route? What route would you like to see? What would you like to see next? But anyways, guys, thank you so much for joining and supporting the channel. Until next time, remember you have three choices. Give up, give in, or give it all you got. Peace, love, and God bless you. I will see you guys next time, next video. I'm out.